Tony Braxton from Sex and Cigarettes. That's the CD before. What? Where's that coming from? Hang on. No, it stopped. There's different sounds here. I thought I'd closed out the other one. Anyway, I've tweeted WENOTNO a link to a Guardian article from Monday, I think it was, which was all about Napster, which has been bought and it's going to become something else. But it's got a very interesting chart in it, about halfway down the article, which shows physical sales of music from 2001 going down, and then streaming from about 2010 starting to go up, and it's now going up quite quickly. And I think that explains a bit about HMV, and also why John normally thinks I'm a bit off the point worrying about CDs anyway. Chris is much the same in the Wild Show, but I still like CDs, so I sort of have them as a backup. And today, when John's a bit late, it's a very good thing I have got my bag of CDs here as well, as well as John's playlist on YouTube and whatever else we can find. But what I wanted to say is that some of this works in my head as fiction. So I'm sitting in for the storyteller, and I've sort of gradually taken over the drama show on a Thursday before the Wild Show. And it oscillates really between fiction and reality. I sort of imagine things, not so much in character, more in time and place, I would say. As well as playing clips from other people, but to the extent that I'm contributing any sort of drama, that's how it seems to work. And then the news catches up with us a bit. So I do talk to the storyteller every so often. He's away at the moment. He was on the Extinction Rebellion events, and now I think he's heading towards France. He is concerned about Brexit and thinks it's going to get more difficult, so it's fairly determined to go there, I think, with the Widsith and Dior Theatre. They usually do an autumn tour, and there's possibly still time for that. Where was I going with this? Yes, we can't work out what's going on with the campus and that going online. It's sort of by analogy. All comparisons are weak, I suppose, but we may be 10 or 15 years behind for education with what music has done. The sort of details of that I'll fill in on a later occasion. So in other words, the stand-up philosopher will at some point project it into the future in a sci-fi sort of way, offer an opinion, I'm hoping, on what happened to the campus as it moved online. We're thinking about the ruins of the Fortress University. One of the things I'll definitely say is that Peter Horrocks' lecture in Durham about 3 years ago about why investment in future learning was a good idea, and how the campus could be opened up. I think it's well worth going back having a look. If anybody would just like to find that on YouTube and add a comment, or perhaps do a response video. I don't think we can just play clips of it on the radio, or edit it and pick out the aspects that I think are interesting. I'm not sure whether we can do that sort of thing. Probably not. But I think response videos, if people make them Creative Commons, or send me a copy, or let me just indicate it's okay to quote that. That would be quite interesting, because I think that whole situation is changing. We don't know what's going to happen during the new academic year, what will happen with the pandemic or the regulations or the online, whether the online's just an emergency or whether there's a design to it. Anyway, it's good in some ways being here by yourself. You can just rave on. But I think I'm going to go back to John's playlist. The Lynyrd Skynyrd. Jimmy McGriff, the Groovefly. And well, I may come back to the playout system now and again. I've just faded it out. I've faded it out properly now. Today is a conference, Tech Exeter, which is online. It's completely online this time. Previous couple of times it's been at the business school on the campus, the University of Exeter. But I think it's at Collider today. And so they are going to have a very good knowledge of how to act as a studio. The idea of the studio is getting quite various. And they're a sort of television studio, I guess. I think the video is going to be available for the people who've attended, and then maybe some bits of it will appear elsewhere. I don't know. Ideas will get out as to what was said anyway. The one which interests me is, I think, happening at the moment, which is a deep learning for object detection. Software Solved is the Twitter connection. Software Solved, all one word. And it seems to be about objects, as in insurance. That's the application I've found through Twitter. So I've just got a vague idea what it's about. But it's like doing surveys of what sort of items are in a property or space, and what you can know about them. But I guess it would apply to other things as well. But it's interesting they've called it deep learning, because eventually, if learning is online and they put AI behind it, it could develop in all sorts of ways. Will they have deep learning about sounds? So in other words, John, I'm not trying to get rid of you. I'm hoping you'll turn up quite shortly. But if we've got a playlist of John's taste, can we come up with another one? So forth. That would be interesting. Or yacht disco, which is a genre that never existed a while ago, but yacht rock existed. And I talked to JD about this. Could there be something called yacht disco? And lo and behold, there was. If you did a search for it, it's already been done. But it all sounds as if it's been put together by... Well, I think the tracks probably were put together by computer, but the playlists have been put together by computer as well. And possibly without anybody ever understanding what yacht disco is. Anyway, going back to John's playlist, just to confuse us possibly, and this was some time ago, but I think this is still one he might select. It's called Story of My Life, One Direction. Oh no, sorry, there's one more thing to say about Digital Exeter and Tech Exeter, which is all this stuff about the campus moving online. I don't think Digital Exeter's going to cover that at the moment, because the university's not really back. It's all happening at Collider, and there's not a lot of clarity as to what's going on, how much of the new year is going to be back to normal, or online in a planned way, or alternative sort of way. None of that's at all clear, but I think that's just something we'll come back to at some point, and I would think Digital Exeter will have a view on it at some point in time. Street Arts Festival was cancelled, unfortunately. I think they made a very solid effort to have some live performance going on in Exeter. Maybe it was just too successful. It was building up too much, and it would have caused too much blockage, or too many people close together in Exeter, as it looked to be happening. But I think online it still worked. There was a lot of material online, both before and after. And I've been trying to work with the Street Arts Exeter hashtag. I'm very keen on hashtags, but I'm not sure it's really necessary anymore. The AI behind the search, or behind whatever it is, whether it's Twitter or YouTube or various other ones, whatever words you put in, it seems to have lots of them that it's considering. So the official hashtag is only one option, and I notice some people don't use it as much as they used to. Digital Exeter did explain to me through a tweet that the Vision 2020 Exeter tag is really only used for people who already know about it. So a lot of the tweets they were doing promoting the event used much more general tags. So if you're into all this sort of thing, you should pay close attention to the Digital Exeter Twitter feed over the next couple of days. I'm sure it will all be fully explained. The other thing I've tweeted about is a link to Manifesto for Teaching Online, which is coming from Edinburgh University and a lot of other people that they know. There's going to be 3 online events over the next 6 weeks or so, I think it is. So we'll do a lot more about that in the future, and that may tie back to Digital Exeter and whatever's going on in Exeter. We don't know, but we'll try and see what connections there are with that.